Your Honor, at this time, the people have no choice other than to ask this court to impose the maximum sentence that can be imposed by law for the conviction of gross vehicular manslaughter while intoxicated. While Mr. Mayhew has, to this time, led a fairly blameless life, his actions on the night in question led to the irretrievable loss of three human lives. At the very least, this court must impose the 10-year maximum sentence of human lives. At the very least, this court must impose the 10-year maximum sentence of human lives. At the very least, this court must impose the 10-year maximum sentence along with 2 additional years for the 2 additional fatalities. Mr. Mayhew is incredibly fortunate that the jury in this case did not return a verdict of murder in the second degree, which we argued for vigorously, but it did agree that his actions were grossly negligent and his actions clearly deserve the maximum punishment that can be imposed by law. The only way justice can be served in this matter is if Mr. Mayhew spends 12 years in the California Department of Corrections and Rehabilitation. Thank you.
My bones, it goes electric wavy when I turn it on. Off to my city.
Hey, how was last night?
Oh, it was fun. You know, after school, me and Alan went to get some frozen yogurt with my calculus.
So, yeah, how'd that go?
Yeah, it was fun. I mean, we're ready for the test, so that's a good thing.
That's good.
You heard back from any of the colleges?
Heard back from a couple, but I'm just still up in the air about them.
You still thinking about going to Colorado with me?
Well, yeah.
Well, I mean, I'm supposed to find out today, so I mean, maybe once I find out, you can tell me, so we can go get a place together, you know?
Yeah.
Because everything's just going so great with us, I want to be with you, because, you know, I love you.
Aw. Well, I gotta go to class,
right.
So I'll see you.
Yeah.
Cause I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet, I feel that hot blood in my body, when it drops, ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally, you're more like the way we rock it, so don't stop, stop, got a little lights.
Get to class!
Hello? Hi, have I reached Joe Mayhew, please?
This is him.
Hi, Joe. My name is Roger Cranston. I'm calling from University of Colorado. You had applied recently for admission to our school?
I did, yes.
Yes. I'm terribly sorry to have to tell you, but I'm afraid that while we may have indicated otherwise, we're going to be unable to admit you this year. I really have to make calls like this, and I really apologize for what I'm sure is probably a letdown.
Your protagonist, he will find out about some trauma. Something is going to happen in his life that this is the starting point from. So if you're looking for like a hero's journey perspective, it's your goal here. It's definitely not working. We got this. Plot point one would happen right about here for like 2 o'clock. That's about 15 minutes into the movie. So, at this point, your hero's living his normal life, where maybe he's going to college, he has a girlfriend, and that's usually what makes a movie important.
the world away for a minute. Pretend I don't live in it. Sunshine gonna wash my blues away. Had sweet love, but I lost it. She got too close, so far, and now I'm lost in the world trying to find me a better way. Wishing I was knee-deep in the water somewhere. Got the blue sky breeze and it don't seem fair. Only worry in the world is the tide gonna reach my chair. Sunrise, there's a fire in the sky. Never been so happy, never felt so high. And I think I might have found me my own kind of paradise. Wrote a note, said be back in a minute. Bought a boat and I sailed off in it. Don't think anybody's gonna miss me anyway. Mind on a permanent vacation.
Hey, what up, man?
Hey, what up, dude?
Hey, you good? Why? What happened?
My medical cup. Oh, you good?
Whatever.
No problem, man.
You wanna fix your problems?
I don't know if I should.
Come on, man, let's party.
From the company, right?
Yeah!
Emergency, we're reporting a car accident. Okay, where? In front of the high school on Pine and Fowler. Okay, are there any injuries? There is. It looks like there's some really bad injuries. There's a couple people that were thrown from one of the vehicles. Okay, is there more than one car involved? Yes, there's a truck and a Jeep. Okay. Did you see the accident, ma'am? I did. Okay. Do you know what happened? It looks like they might have ran one of the vehicles ran the stop sign. Okay. Were you involved at all? No, I wasn't. Okay. All right. And the roadway is blocked, you said? Yes. Okay. We've got help on the way, okay? All right. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Jade was 16 years old and will be remembered by her loved ones as always smiling and loved by all.
Hey, who wants a ride?
All around me are familiar faces, worn out places, worn out faces, bright and early for the daily. Drown my sorrow, no tomorrow, no tomorrow. And I find it kind of funny, I find it kind of sad. The dreams in which I'm dying are the best I've ever had. I find it hard to tell you, I find it hard to take. When people run in circles, it's a very, very mad world. Mad world. Children waiting for the day they feel good. Happy birthday, happy birthday. And I feel the child should sit and listen, sit and listen. Went to school and I was very nervous. No one knew me, no one knew me. Hello teacher, tell me what's my lesson. Look right through me, look right through me. I'm dying, are the best I've ever had. I find it hard to tell you, I find it hard to take. When people run in circles, it's a very, very mad world.
This car, and we just wrecked, and I don't know what happened. We were just driving. I'm at the police station.
In streams I walked alone, narrow streets of cobblestone, beneath the halo of a street lamp, I turned my collar to the cold and damp. When my eyes were stunned by the flash of a neon light that split the night and touched the sound of silence, I saw the light fade from the sky. On the wind I held a sigh. As the snowflakes cover my fallen brothers, I will say this last goodbye. Night is now falling, so ends this day. The road is now calling, the way over hill and under tree, through lands where never light is shone, by silver streams that run down to the sea, under cloud, beneath the stars, over snow. Winter's morn, I turn at last to paths that lead home, and oh, where the road then takes me, I cannot tell. We came all this way, but now comes the day to bid you farewell. Places I have been, many sorrows I have seen, but I don't regret, nor will I forget all who took that road with me. Night is now away, over hill
by silver streams that run down to the sea. To these memories I will hold, with your blessing I will go, to turn at last to paths that lead home. And oh, where the road then takes me, I cannot tell. We came all this way, but now comes the day to bid you farewell.
It was a very good year. It was a very good year for small town girls and soft summer nights. We'd hide from the lights on the village green. When I was 17, when I was 21, it was a very good year. It was a very good year for city girls who lived up the stair with all that perfumed hair. And it came undone when I was 21.